Yes.
And the third person of the Trinity, the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
Amen. It's just good to be here.
Amen.
Amen. We thank God for another day.
Yes.
Amen. Another opportunity. Amen. To fellowship and to praise the Lord. Amen. Amen. I'm going to ask if you would turn with me to the gospel as recorded by the Dr. Luke.
Ooh, amen.
Amen. Luke. There we will look at the sixth chapter. Luke chapter number six. Chapter number six. Amen. We'll read verse 46 through verse 49. Luke chapter number six. Verse 46. Through verse 49. Amen. Amen. You know you have it by your amen.
Amen.
Amen. Read Luke chapter number 6, starting at verse number 46. Reads as follows. And why call ye me Lord, Lord, and do not the things which I say? Whosoever cometh to me and heareth my sayings and doeth them, I will show you to whom he is like. He is like a man which built an house and dig deep and laid the foundation on a rock. And when the flood arose, the stream beat vehemently upon the house and could not shake it, for it was founded upon a rock. But he that heareth and doeth not is like a man that without a foundation built a house upon the earth, and against which the stream did beat vehemently, and immediately it fell, and the ruin of that house was great.
Amen.
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 Amen. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Amen. 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 For a subject, amen. For a thought to, amen. Anger on, amen. We want to ask you a question this morning, amen, from that, amen, we derive from this scripture of reading, amen. What kind of builder are you?
Yes.
Amen. What kind of builder are you? Amen. Let's just thank you. You may be seated. What kind of builder are you? Amen. 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 The Apostle Paul said in Romans chapter number 10, verse 1 through verse 3, the Apostle Paul wrote some words that sound like this. He said, brethren, my heart's desire and prayer to God for Israel is that they might be saved. For I bear them record that they have a zeal of God, but not according to the knowledge, for they being ignorant of God's righteousness, and going about to establish their own righteousness, have not submitted themselves unto the righteousness of God. Amen, amen. And Jesus said in Matthew chapter number 11, verse 29 through 30, Jesus said, take my yoke upon you, and learn of me, for I am meek and lowly in heart, and you shall find rest for your soul. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. Amen. Amen. One of the greatest fallacies of the 21st century church is that we like to have church, amen, but we struggle, amen, we struggle with being the church born and established by Jesus Christ. Amen. 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 One of our greatest struggles, amen. We don't mind having church. Amen, amen. But we struggle with being
and becoming disciples. Amen. The struggle is not merely with merely looking like we perceive the church is supposed to look like. We got that down already. Amen. We know how we're supposed to look. Amen. However, the great struggle is being discipled and made, amen, to look more like Jesus Christ. Amen. We know how to dress up. Amen. We know how, amen, to look all holy. Amen. We know how, amen, to sit up. Amen. To stoop. Amen. We even know how to wave our hands at a given time. Amen. We even know how to say amen. Amen. But that's not the greatest struggle. Amen. Our struggle is, amen, is to become more and more like Jesus Christ. Yes, yes, yes. The reason why is being a disciple, amen, to look more like Christ requires some radical changes, amen, in the way that we are used to operating. Amen, amen. Paul said in 1 Corinthians, amen, chapter 15, he said, if any man be in Christ Jesus, amen, he is a new creation. Amen. Am I right about it? Amen. Amen. And Paul says, amen, in Romans chapter number 12, verse 1 and 2, Paul said, I beseech you therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that ye present your body a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. Then he said, and be not conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that ye may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. In other words, what they are conveying, amen, if we are going to be the church that Jesus, amen, was talking about when he told Peter, upon this rock I build my church, amen, we have to understand, amen, there's got to be some radical changes made in each and every one of us.
Yes.
Amen. 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 But in order for this to happen, we must build our spiritual house.
Yes.
Our life on a solid foundation.
Yes.
Amen. Being Jesus Christ by applying the instruction given to the church. Amen. By Jesus Christ, who is the head of the church. Amen. The one who established and died for the church. Mm-hmm. Amen. The one that John said, amen, in Revelation chapter 1, verse 20, he described him as the one who walks among the seven candlesticks. Amen. That is the church. Amen. Amen. Jesus. Amen. If we are going to be, amen, master builders, good builders, amen, we have to become more and more like the architect of the church. Amen. Jesus. Amen. Christ was a carpenter by trade and profession.
Yes.
Amen. Amen. And if anybody knew houses, amen, Jesus knew houses.
That's right.
Amen. Not only did he know houses, amen, but he knew the building trade.
Yes.
Amen. Am I right about it? Amen.
Right.
He knew Jesus knew that the house was only as good, amen, as the foundation that it is built on. Amen. 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 No matter how high you build it, amen, no matter how wide you build it, amen, no matter how many rooms you build on to it, amen, if the foundation is good, amen, the house is good. Amen. But if the foundation is faulty, amen, the house will be faulty and it will soon fall down. Amen. Jesus said, as a matter of fact, Jesus said in that last verse, in verse number 49, he said, great will be the fall.
Yes.
Amen. If the house is built,
yes,
on a faulty foundation. Amen. Even though Jesus, in this body scripture, uses the references of house building. Amen. What he is really talking about is the life that we build and how we build.
Yes.
Amen. Am I right about it? Amen. He wasn't just barely talking about, amen, these dwelling places. Amen. These physical dwelling places. Amen. That we, amen, dwell in. Amen. But he was talking about, amen, our life. Amen. And the life of believers and non-believers and how they are constructed.
Yes.
Amen. 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 As a matter of fact, he starts out, amen, and I like Jesus' because, amen, I love him so much, amen, because he always give us a good example, amen. He started out, he said, the good builder, amen. He said, he's aware of and knows the importance of starting out the building process with a good foundation.
Yes.
Amen, amen. Let me tell you something, amen. Don't you dare try to build a house, amen, without first laying a foundation. Amen. Don't you dare try to build a life, amen, without having a good foundation for life.
Amen.
He understands, amen. He understands that the part that you don't see, amen, is more than the part that you do see.
Amen.
Let me tell you something. Amen. Even though the house may look good, amen, it may look like an expensive edifice, amen.
Yes.
Amen. If the foundation, amen, is weak and cracked and shaky, amen, I don't care how good the house looks, amen, sooner or later, amen, stress will do what? Make the house crumble to a fall. Jesus was pointing out the first thing he said about the good building, he said, the first thing he does is he devotes time and study and familiarizing himself with the blueprint to give him guidelines and an order to go by to be.
Amen.
A good builder don't just grab some lumber and some nails and a hammer and just go to build it. Amen. First of all, amen, he sits down, amen, and he looks at the blueprint.
Amen.
And the directions that are encased in the blueprint, amen, that was given to him, amen, by the architect who drew up the house, amen, in order that he might know how to properly build the house.
Right.
But before he ever started building, before he ever erected any wall, amen, the good builder understands before he build up, he first got to dig down.
Yes.
And the reason why he has to dig down is because he has to find a good solid bedrock.
Yes.
To lay the foundation on before he builds up. Amen. Have you ever seen some of these houses, amen, that, especially in our day and time, and, amen, it seems like they pop a house up in 3 days, amen, but
right.
You give them 10 years later, amen, here they are, got to have the house jacked up.
Yes.
Amen, because what? It was built on faulty foundation. Because they didn't take the time, amen, to make sure, amen, they were building on a good foundation. The good builder, the first thing he does, amen, he digs down until he finds, amen, that good solid bedrock, amen, that he can lay the foundation of the house on. Amen. And not only does he do that, amen, and also the good builder, he has disciplined himself to stick with the plan and step provided by the architect that the house may be able to withstand the shifting the movement of the earth and still be solid and stable. Amen. Let me tell you something. The good builder, amen, number one, he makes sure that he has a good foundation, amen, and then he's disciplined enough, amen, to stick with the plan and the steps, amen, provided by the architect, amen, who drew up the blueprint, amen, to show how the house is supposed to be built, amen. He sticks with each and every step, amen. Let me tell you something. We get in trouble, amen, when we start circumventing the plan, amen, and skipping over steps.
Yeah.
Oh, come on, talk to me. Amen. The good builder, amen. He don't deviate, amen, from what the architect. Amen. Have grown up, amen, and placed in the plan, amen, to show how, amen, this house can be best put together. Amen. Oh God, let me let me just deviate. Amen. You know how it is, y'all, when we go to a store, amen, get some of that knockdown furniture. Y'all know what knockdown furniture is, don't you?
Yes.
Amen. That furniture, amen. That,